The Indian National Congress, from being a dominant force in Puducherry, has suffered a massive setback. The party managed to win only two seats in the 30-member house in the recent elections. After being unable to stop its own legislators from defecting to BJP and All India NR Congress, the Narayana Swamy-led government fell in February 2021. The BJP, in the meantime, has grown as a huge force and even becoming a part of the Rangaswamy-led government in the Union Territory, from being an insignificant player until recently. The AIADMK, after wielding considerable influence in the 1970s, has lost prominence and won no seats this time. The DMK managed to win 6 seats in the elections but remained non-committal when the rift was widening between the Lieutenant Governor and the previous Congress government. Will the Congress, DMK and AIADMK be able to survive and rise again? We have with us Mr. Radhakrishnan, the Associate Editor of Frontline, to discuss.
Congress has been limited to a very small force. They are reduced to just 2 members in the present house. So what do you say in Congress? Do they have a future, you know, just after occupying the power for so long? What is the future of the Congress in Puducherry?
The future of the Congress in Puducherry is linked to the future of the Congress in India. I would say that the Congress party as an entity has to die out, and we need a responsible opposition come in its place. Now, the unfortunate thing is that the Congress is refusing to die out, and at the same time, it's refusing to become a political party. So we have Rahul Gandhi sitting there, and he will release white papers and black papers and blue papers and yellow papers, but he will not take responsibility of running the party. He will not take responsibility of even an election. We saw that in Tamil Nadu. Why did DMK and Congress end up losing seats in Kanyakumari, which is a place where it should have won every single seat? It is because Priyanka Gandhi was supposed to come for a campaign. I think this was April 1 or 2 or whatever. And then suddenly her husband gets COVID. So she refuses to come. And Rahul Gandhi should have stepped in. He should have come there. So instead, what happens is that instead of giving that final push in Kanyakumari, what we see is that the DMK leaders also were forced to halt their campaign on those crucial days in Kanyakumari and concentrate elsewhere, because without Congress, Kanyakumari doesn't make sense. If there was a central leader, you would have seen both Austin and Suresh Rajan winning their elections, and you would have seen all the 6 seats going to the Congress, DMK combined. So this is the kind of irresponsibility that we have seen from the first family of the Congress. And this family either needs to get out of the scene or take responsibility for its actions. So unless that happens, I don't see a revival of the party either in Puducherry or in any other part of India. But as long as they remain at the helm, again, it becomes a crippling problem for the Congress that they don't... This is kind of freedom without responsibility, wherein the children can come and do exactly as they please and walk out exactly as they please, take holidays when they want to, and then come back and Congress has some kind of ancestral property which they can generally trample upon. I think that has to change first before the Congress becomes a viable combine for Puducherry or for India itself.
Sir, with all these issues, with the tussle between BJP and ANRC going on, do you see any political realignment in the Union Territory with the role of DMK or Congress or ANRC coming together, anything like that? Is it possible there?
I don't think so. I don't think there is any realignment possible, because BJP basically works on breaking parties and taking away people to its own side. And that is what is happening in ADMK in Tamil Nadu. That is exactly what has happened in between the ADMK and BJP in the Union Territory. Now, the next thing that will happen is likelihood of breaking up this ANRC, which is a very powerful political force in Puducherry, and part of its members going off with the BJP. So that is their game plan. And I don't think there is a huge desire on the part of the DMK to stand in the way at all, because DMK, the stakes are for the BJP is very high. And the returns, as far as the DMK is concerned, is too low. So, because even if you come to power, you can't do much. That is a fact in the Union Territory. Only if you're aligned with the government in center can you do anything. And that is that will not happen unless the BJP is with you. If the BJP and the DMK are in alliance with Puducherry, I think that will be enough for the people of Tamil Nadu to throw the DMK out in any election from now on. And you remember that the local body elections are about to happen, and the Supreme Court has spelled out an order on that. So given this circumstance and the fact that the Congress is a house in disarray, I don't see any political realignment in Puducherry happening at all for a very long point of time. All I see is that a gradual weakening of the Rangasamy Congress and members of the Rangasamy Congress, including MLAs, switching sides and going over to the BJP.
Sir, there are the two other Dravidian parties, the DMK and ADMK, which wields considerable influence in Tamil Nadu, are very small or less influential forces in Puducherry. So do you see any, you know, that these two parties gathering strength from the weakening ANRC or Indian National Congress?
No, I don't see that either, because I think the idea of either Dravidian parties ruling Puducherry has there from the time that electoral politics came to Puducherry. You remember the first election that MGR won was not in Tamil Nadu, it was in Puducherry. And the moment that MGR had thoughts of making Puducherry a part of Tamil Nadu, the ADMK lost its relevance and lost its majority and finally became the first government to fall. So this is history. Now you look at the DMK, it's not, again, who are the members in the DMK? John Kumar was in the DMK, for heaven's sake. Till 2016, he was in the DMK. Till 2021, he was in the Congress, and then he moved over. So what we see in all these political parties is that, these IRAMs and Gayarams are part of every political setup. So it's not the ideology that drives, people in power into various political parties. It's just convenience. So at one point of time, it was very convenient for John Kumar to be in the DMK. He was in the DMK. And then he moves over to the Congress because Congress becomes the ruling party. So as long as this is the situation, that is, anyone with a large amount of money wins the election, Puducherry can be no different from any other state in India, at least most of the states in India, where money decides who wins and who loses. I think it's for the people of Puducherry to decide after what they've seen happen for the past 50 days.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.